movement is health. I think in a healthy body, we cultivate a healthy energy. Disease or illness is due to slowing down our energy. And one of the reasons we're slowing down the energy because we lose possibilities for movement and we don't move enough. Now, our body is designed to move. Our body is made of different joints or hinges, starting from ankle joint, knee joint, hips, lumbar area, all the vertebras, along with sternum and thorax and neck. And all these joints need to get some lubrication. The synovial fluid needs to get compression and decompression. And we can have that through the movement. And where movement starts? The movement starts in our feet. Feet are our foundation. 26 bones made one foot. So 52 bones contain of both feet. 25% of all bones in our body are located in our feet. There's tremendous mobility in our feet. Foot eversion, aversion, plantar flexion, dorsal flexion, digit flexion, extension. So tremendous amount of movement. Maybe you have seen somewhere people who lost their hands or lost their ability to make some activities for their hands, and they had to relearn the sensitivity and movement through the feet. And you can see how tremendous, amazing things people can do through their feet. Driving car, painting, riding, so much mobility in our foot. And we lose that connection with the foot due to wearing shoes or due to lack of the movement. So I would like to encourage you, keep on moving, walk, run, Tai Chi, Qigong, yoga, a movement that will help to mobilize all the joints, will help to oil up and lubricate the synovial fluid in between joints, so you can have much freer movement, and that will create tremendous amount of energy in your body. The energy will be able to flow freely through your body, and that is health. So keep on moving and enjoy the movement. Touch is an important part of our health. It's a fifth sense. We are developing sense of touch already in 7 week or fetal development. When we are already 2 months old, we start sensing what is the touch, how we can perceive the world through the touch. Important part to understand about touch, that during the touch, our body is releasing hormones of happiness and contentment, oxytocin, dopamine, serotonin, all this surge into our system so we feel good. 10 or 20 second hug with somebody can tremendously change your state, bring more happiness, bring more contentment. Touch can be used on various different ways. We can use touch for alignment, for body work, like myofascial energetic release or rolfing, to work on the soft tissue and the fascia of the body. Touch can be used in much softer ways, like craniosacral therapy or Reiki, more energetical, subtle ways to work on parasympathetic nervous system to bring more calm and relaxation. Touch can be used to heal so many different conditions like depression, anxiety, a lot of different skin problems, ADHD, and many other disorders related to our nervous system, because it is calming down, brings more relaxation and feeling good sense. Another interesting fact about touch is our skin, if we spread it up on canvas, it takes up about 2 square meters of the surface. And the surface contains of nociceptors, the nerve endings. And so by touching our body, we are influencing directly our nervous system to bring more relaxation and more peace. So touch for me is in a very important part of my life. When I was in my 20s, suffering from depression, from a lot of pains, I found an amazing therapist for Lomi Lomi Nui massage. I was receiving in this period of my life about 40, 50 sessions over 2 years' time, and it tremendously changed my life, and I believe it opened my thirst for spirituality, for search, opened up for my feelings, emotions, and brought me to a state of health. So find a way to be intimate with the touch, be touchy, and connect through the touch with others. Gratitude is a very powerful feeling, statement. I am grateful. I am gratitude. When we are in a state of gratitude, we are in a state of empowerment. We're taking responsibility for our life. Very often I see that people go into disempower themselves and being in a state of victim, saying things like, or it happened to me, or this is because of my past, this is because of my parents, the country I was born, this is because of my genes, etc., etc. Every time we make this kind of statement, we take a power away from ourselves. With I am grateful, we are bringing gratitude to whatever we have, whatever we are in this lifetime, and we can create ourselves in whatever way we want. When we are in a state of gratitude, we radiate with this happy energy, and we attract more beautiful things in our life. I practice gratitude every morning after a wake up and meditation. I do journaling and I write at least 3 things that I am grateful for this day. And it can be something as simple as I'm grateful for the air, I'm grateful for the sun shining on my skin, I'm grateful for my family, for abundance, I'm grateful for being alive, I'm grateful for everything that is in present moment in my life. What it does, it creates, connects you with very high vibration and state of that everything is completed, that you don't have to chase for anything, that you don't need to worry about anything, because everything is provided for you to live happy and healthy life. So I invite you to practice, journal about gratitude, and remind yourself every day to stay in the state of gratitude. Don't compare yourself with anybody else. Everybody else is on different path. If you start comparing yourself, you are losing connection to gratitude. You be grateful for everything you are, and this will tune you up with a state of gratitude and happiness. Is one of the most important functions in our body. When we take deep inhalation, the oxygen comes into the lungs, and in small air sac alveoli comes the diffusion. The oxygen comes into the bloodstream and gets delivered to every cell to produce the energy. And from alveoli, we expel carbon dioxide. So the major function of breath would be delivering energy, but also detoxifying our body, releasing from the body carbon dioxide and all the toxic waste product released from the cells. Amazing function of the breath is also massaging also all abdominal region. Our diaphragm, the major breath muscle, when we engage fully diaphragmatic breath, it opens up and massages intestines, stomach, liver, pancreas. Also, the diaphragm is through the ligament attached to our heart and surrounded by pericardium. So with deep diaphragmatic breath, we are also massaging our heart. We're bringing more blood circulation into our body. Breath can also change our state. Imagine if you are in fear, how is your breath? Usually it's very rapid and shallow. And then imagine when you are in a state of relaxation, then your breath would be slower and deeper. So in this sense, we can impact our state. Very often when throughout the day, I want you to be in more a sympathetic, activated state. I use more vigorous, rapid, deeper breath. And in the evenings, when I want to go more to parasympathetic rest and digest mode, I slow down my breath to 4-5 breaths a minute. That helps to balance out between sympathetic and parasympathetic, and use your breath depending to your state. My favorite way of breathing in the morning, I really love doing oceanic spine movement. This is the movement where I breathe deeply with connected breath, with open mouth, delivering a lot of oxygen into my lungs, and I bring that movement like a wavy, opening up all vertebrae in my body, opening up my heart, my diaphragm, all the digestive system, all the core tissue in the body open up. So this is really amazing way to open up all the tissue and the fascial structure in the body after a whole night. The other way of breathing that I really like is to do 4-5 breaths a minute. You can do it in form of meditation, like in Vipassana, sitting and just focusing on your breath. That makes about 3 seconds on inhalation, 3-4 seconds on exhalation, and give a gap in between inhalation and exhalation for about 2 seconds. That will make about 5 breaths a minute and will slow down, will bring more relaxation and bring more clarity for your mind and more peace for your being. So keep on breathing, stay present, and enjoy the breath. Meditation for me is the best medication. It's a medication that helps us to maintain state of peace, mindfulness, and presence. We all grew up with different unhealthy habits, patterns, or conditionings, and meditation is one of the way to bring more light and bring more awareness into those patterns. For example, sometimes if I catch myself complaining or whining, I can step back and before going into that complaints, check inside what it gives me that I want to complain, and bring that awareness how I can come out of that state of victim into living my full empowerment. Meditation helps us to live life out of unhealthy habits, and then I can change my habits into something else, something more positive. Let's say instead of complaining, I can go with praising somebody or give a good feedback or being in a state of gratitude. So meditation helps us to bring awareness into whatever we say, whatever we do, whatever we think, and whatever we feel. It gives us this sense of empowerment that we are responsible for ourselves and we can change anything in our lives. Very often I work with people who are addicted to certain substances, and one thing that really works well is meditation. So for example, next time when you catch that cigarette, when you are in this state of anxiety that you want to take another path, I recommend you stay for a moment in meditation. Take a few minutes to really observe yourself. Where is this anxiety in your body? Where, what is the feeling related to it? And I assure you, after a few minutes, it will also pass. Nothing stays, emotions, feelings, sensations, it's all dynamic, comes and goes. So nothing lasts forever. And that's why meditation is so powerful, because it helps us understand the dynamic in life and helps us to change our unhealthy pattern into healthy response. So we're not reacting anymore into external environment by by throwing out tantrum or reacting with anger or rage, but instead we can respond to that factors in more mindful and aware way. We also bringing all awareness to all our emotions and feelings as energy. Emotions is an energy, so through the meditation we can embrace our feelings and express our feelings in mindful, conscious way. One of my favorite way of meditation is Vipassana, which I love doing in the morning, where you sit with straight spine and you bring awareness to inhalation, exhalation, and you scan your body from the feet up to the head and from the head down to the feet, just simply bringing awareness to the felt sense, to the bodily sensations. Another meditations that I really like doing is active Osho meditation. It could be dynamic or kundalini, chakra breathing, but I also bring awareness and meditation into dancing, moving, walking, or even when I jog, I bring that awareness and checking my body moment to moment. So I invite you, keep on meditation. You know, to bring a new habit in life, it takes sometimes 21 days in a row. So I invite you, take this challenge for 21 days every morning, engage into morning meditation, Vipassana, or chakra breathing, or Osho dynamic meditation. And after 21 days, it will become your daily habit. Enjoy the meditation. Today's topic, emotions. So let's start from defining what is really emotion. Emotion comes from two words, emotion. It's an energy in motion. That's why emotions are dynamic. They're like seasons of the year. They're changing. They never last for a long time. Every emotion has specific sensations in the body. Out of external environment, our body releases specific chemicals that run through the body, creating those sensations. And we translate those sensations into feelings, into emotions. And sometimes those sensations might be unpleasant, and can we call it bad sensations, you know? And we tend to avoid those emotions that are related. And on the other hand, we try to bring those emotions that have these pleasant sensations. So this is a little bit like cutting off half of our energy. But the idea of feelings is that we surrender to feelings. We allow the feelings, no matter how pleasant or unpleasant our sensations, but that understanding that this is just energy flowing into our system. In this way, we can be open to an idea and being aware of our sensations and our body. Why do I talk about emotions referring to our health? You see, the recent research has been done that our emotions are stored in tissue and fascia. Unexpressed, denied feelings become an emotion that creates some armoring, tension, and sometimes pain in the body. American professor John Sarno, in his best-selling book, Healing Back Pain, was researching in America what is really cause of the back pain, which become an epidemic, huge epidemic in our society. Out of thousands of clients that he worked with, he discovered one thing, that 90% of pain syndromes for his clients were due to unexpressed, denied feelings and contraction in the soft tissue that contract on a nociceptor, the nerve ending causing pain. He called it TMS, tension, myositis syndrome, where myositis stands for muscle inflammation. So thousands of his clients who were immobilized with pain for months or years, by acknowledging and expressing those emotions, got immediately better. It was an amazing news in all medical world in America that actually emotions has huge impact. And I see that also in biodynamic breath and trauma release system, which I am practitioner, facilitator, and I see how much emotions along with breathing and movement help people to come out of trauma and help people to be more aware of their feelings. So I invite you, practice your emotional awareness. How to do it? Simply use the felt sense, use the meditation to scan the body and bring that subtle awareness to all the physical sensations and ask yourself, what is behind those sensations? Because those sensations are connected to our feelings. One last thing, we are feeling constantly. Throughout 24 hours, we're constantly connected to our feeling. Each second, there is certain feeling in our body and they dynamically changing like a seasons of the year. So keep on practicing, become aware of your emotions and express your feelings. Bye-bye.
Intention is connected to manifestation of our reality. 20 years ago, I came across Lomi Lomi Nui massage coming from Hawaiian philosophy, and working with intention and the prayer tremendously changed my life, coming out of depression, pains and aches in my body to a state where I was living full potential and being a healthier person. And why today I want to talk about intention and the prayer in relationship to our health. You see, our intention can change our belief system. And I notice in today's world, so many people talk and want to be healthy. And yet even people who are working and supporting others to be healthy, they struggle. They struggle with their health, with the illness or some pains. And I think big part of it because their subconscious belief system sabotaging their life with wrong diet, lack of movement, and all sort of intoxications that does not keep the body in a healthy state. So today I would like to emphasize and give you a few tips about intention and the prayer, which from Hawaiian comes in a word of haipula, which is sending blessings to higher selves, to intelligence or to God. And those five major steps that I would like to introduce you today is coming from Huna, from Hawaiian philosophy. So in the first step, we need to change our state. Before going into the prayer, into the intention, we need to be in a high energetical state. Why? Because if you're collapsed, if you're in a state of depression, if you are kind of lousy state, you will not even have an idea what could be your full healthy potential. So how to do it? Very easy. 5 to 10 minutes vigorous breathing through the mouth, shake, dance, any sort of activities that can lift your energy up. In the second stage, we're gonna work with the thoughts. Everything in this world is created because the first atom was our thought, and that thought went into the universe and created that particular reality. So close your eyes and think for a moment, what is the intention for my healthy living? In the third stage is your words. Express out loud, at least so you can hear yourself, your intention. Words has really powerful meaning because words create your reality. You send it out to the world to manifest your intention. In the fourth step, it's a visualization. So you can close your eyes in this stage. Imagine you are sitting in the cinema and you project on big screen your intention, your dream health state, and you can put yourself into the video, give it a shape, smell, colors, as many visuals as possible, and imagine how you are when you are in your full potential. And the fifth last step, take at least 3 actions that can take you closer to your intention. And it could be anything. It would be half an hour of movement. It could be going to supermarket and choosing more healthy, more organic and natural products, or stopping buying that next can of Coca-Cola or taking beer. Make 3 actions over today to help you manifest your intention. And working with intention can tremendously support your body to better health. You see, every system in our body is designed for health. Our nervous system, lymphatic, circulatory, respiratory, urinary, all those systems work constantly to bring your more health. If you change your belief system and you start thinking healthy, deserving health and being healthy, all your reality will align to this best version of you, most healthier version of you. So keep on practicing intention in these 5 steps and will tremendously transform your health. Thank you. Bye bye.
We are what we eat. There's so many different diets, keto diet, intermittent fasting, vegan, gluten-free, so many different variations, vegetarianism. But what I like to talk about is what food we have to avoid to impact our health. And those food I called crap food, where C stands for carbonated drinks, sodas, all drinks that contain a lot of sugar and colorants. R stands for refined sugar. If you go to supermarket, most of the product you will find in ingredients sugar. That includes even sometimes water. A stands for artificial foods, all sort of cheap snacks that really contain so much chemicals. P stands for processed food, genetically modified food that has been changed so much that our digestive system can't even process this very well. I would like to invite you to pay attention to avoid this crap food. And I believe most of today's illnesses, cancer, heart attack, diabetes, even depression or pain syndrome have a cause with not good food, the food that has been processed, added sugar, and has been artificially modified. Another important thing I would like to mention is intake of water. Good quality hydration is so important. I used to get so tired not getting enough water or drinking tap water in the city. And then I changed to drinking 3 to 5 liters good quality pH water, 9.4. And today I can run sometimes 2-3 week-long trainings back to back for 8 to 10 hours teaching people body work or breath work. And I don't get tired. And one of the reasons is because of very good hydration. I like to think of food also as a nourishment, as a gift from God's. So I take time for my meals. I prepare meals that they have good taste, a good smell. They are visually beautiful. According to Ayurvedic approach from India, food has to have at least 5 different colors in each meal to be well digested. So I take time for my meals. I don't rush. I spend it with people I like. And I send gratitude to Earth for growing these amazing gifts. I send gratitude to the sun. I send gratitude to people who are harvesting the food and delivering this food. So I think for me, it's about being really in a state of meditation and appreciation of these amazing gifts. Choosing local, fresh, organic products that can really nourish ourselves and be well digested. Ancient Kemetic proverb says, our body is what the food are, and our soul is what our thoughts are. So I invite you to really choose food that is really nourishing, that you can enjoy, have fun with, and take good time to digest, and take good time to enjoy the food. And now I'm gonna go to enjoy my dragon fruit, one of my favorite fruits. So have a good day and enjoy your food.